For our last story tonight, we're back in the studio to listen to a piece of music from Mick Citroen Walsh. Welcome back, Mick. We saw you a couple of months ago with your song about Kilkenny, 21 Steps.
Yes.
Now, you've gone up from the 21 Steps and written a song, The High Street Blues. What's it all about?
Well, it was one Saturday morning, late last year, I was walking down High Street and I looked around and I saw a lot of changes. Number one was a musician who was playing the accordion. He was able to play the accordion, no problem. But he was playing different music. It wasn't Irish music. And it kind of kicked in my head saying, well, there's a few tourists around here now and they're listening to a man playing music, probably from, could be from their own country or something. Then I walked
forward. We like that too, Mick.
We do, of course. But it was strange because I have a few friends who play around town doing the busking and there's a change. The other changes then I saw were in the family butcher shop, which had been there through thick and thin, had closed its doors.
During the recession.
Was closing the doors that evening, on that Saturday evening. And I got an idea in my head, sure, that would be something different as well. What's going to come instead of it? Mm-hmm. As of yet, I haven't seen anything there. During that particular time of the year, there was a shop. They're the electrical shop, TV shop.
Family business as well.
Family business, yeah. Had moved on out of the High Street, out to a retail park. So I sat down and I was thinking to myself, maybe, what about all the other shops around the town that have come in? Has anybody ever met the owners of them? Like you'd have the phone shops, you'd have the pharmaceutical shops. No one has really met the owner.
So things are changing.
Things are changing.
Even the local education supply shop. Mm. I mean to say there must have been three generations of families that have gone in there to get their school books.
Yeah.
And they're closing as well. So where did you record this song and who did you work with on these two songs?
I recorded it with Joseph O'Freelan out in Freshford. And I had the help of four musicians. Martin Harahan, Eva Phelan and Lotha Verkunen.
Now, you said the songs have been organically recorded. What does that mean?
Well, organically to me, like, is that I got the real musicians in. I've heard recordings, which are very good recordings as well, but they use all the effects from
the keyboards. Techno stuff.
Techno, yeah. You can use a computer sounds, and you don't need a violin, but in my case, I bring in the musicians.
The real musicians.
Old style, like, I suppose you might call it. But they're the best.
Well, listen, thanks very much, Mick, for coming back to see us again.
Thank you for having me. And
we look forward to the next song.
No worries. We'll do our best to keep writing a few more.
Down on the High Street on a Saturday afternoon, hustle and the bustle of the traffic to the tune of an unknown musician playing here since noon. Then a box in his arms playing to the few. High Street Blues, this man's new in town, playing his native music to the tourists all around. High Street Blues, it's time to move on. Send them to the Willy Week before the tourists are all gone. When the shoppers on the street in the autumn afternoon see the family TV shop has gone to somewhere new, talk on the High Street says it's gone to retail park. We hope it does better there when the nights get long and dark. High Street Blues, I wish to stayed on the street, visiting it on Saturday, seeing the lake just far to beat. High Street Blues, I hope it still does well, at Christmas time its window was the best I can tell. Well, a drugstore shop is in its place at the centre of the street, selling perfume, shampoos and aids for the feet. And no one's met the owner, it's a new name on the door. It's kind of kind and friendly and capable of a chore. High Street Blues, I need some shampoo. I'll go in and check it out and find something new. High Street Blues, it's still the same old stuff, just a bigger shop for everyone when the going gets rough. Well, a little bit of history died on Saturday afternoon. When the butcher shop closed its doors and the man was playing his tune. This family shop has been here and survived the thick and thin. Forced to close its doors as last customers came in. High Street Blues, another family shop has gone. It's a changing face of Ireland and it's not gonna stop. High Street Blues, they will never come back. Great places for the news and